Hello, I'm Kate McAlpine, and I'm a science communicator.
Why is it so difficult to understand physicists?
Well, I think that depends a lot on the physicist. Some physicists can break things down so that it's easy for anyone to understand the concepts they're talking about, and some physicists have a harder time getting away from all of the basic information that a physicist takes for granted, like energy and momentum and how those work.
Why do you call yourself a science communicator? How do you become a science communicator?
A science communicator is someone who communicates science. And I got into it by studying both physics and professional writing at Michigan State University. And then I got an internship with the American Physical Society and went on from there. Basically, you're excited about science and you want to share it and get as many people excited and understanding it as possible.
What is the goal of your work?
To tell more people about scientific research and get them excited about it as I am.
Why are you fascinated by particle physics?
Particle physics is the universe at its most fundamental level, the very smallest things that there are that build up everything else. And particle physics is also closely tied in with the four forces of the universe. The strong and weak forces that act inside nuclei, the electromagnetic force that we know from electricity, magnetism, and light, and then gravity. And these are the four forces that run everything. And so I guess the smallest things that build up everything and the forces that make everything work. You find all those in particle physics.
How did the idea occur to you to make a science rap?
If I'm honest, it was a song from Eminem's 8 Mile soundtrack. The one, what, you better lose yourself in the music the moment. Well, there's this, line, he's got to go back to the lab again. And I just thought, what about a scientist who had to go back to the lab again? What if he was writing a rap about his work? And the first rap I ever wrote was a parody of that.
The Large Hadron Rap was a viral superhit with over 6 million clicks on YouTube. How do you explain this success?
A large part luck and the fact that people were already kind of primed to be really interested in the Large Hadron Collider at the time that the rap went online. It was just before the big startup. And I'd meant to get it online before the big startup at some point, but then I was running out of time, so I just kind of threw it online. And I guess the other part, I think, would be that the lyrics actually do explain something. I think the music is good, made by my now brother-in-law, Will Barris. And I think there was something of an innocence about it because we were just, you know, down in the tunnels and detector caverns, goofing off, and it was fun.
What is the role of the internet in science communication?
I think that the role of the internet is to give people a voice to talk back. I guess when a science story comes out, if people are interested, then they talk about it. And also you can get criticism or support for theories or research angles and technologies.
It seems like there are worlds between physics and rap music. Are there also similarities?
It's hard to find something direct between physics and rap music. But physics and music are very intimately linked because a piano, for instance, is made up of many strings and they're all of a particular length so that they'll resonate with a particular frequency and those make up the different notes. Or a woodwind, you cover holes so that you change the resonant frequency of the music and that gives you a resonant frequency of the instrument and that gives you your notes.
It seems you had great fun with your rap videos. What do your colleagues think about your work and your rap projects?
I would say that most of my colleagues are supportive of the rap videos and I mean, the scientists who work on the projects typically are happy to have someone talking about their work and getting other people excited about it. And I guess other science communicators, I'm not really sure what they think, but my friends like it.
What do you think will be the future of science communication?
That's hard to say because it's already changing. You get laboratories and universities doing Twitter posts and online newsletters. So this information is much more accessible than it used to be, I think. Otherwise, you'd have to be getting the university newsletter in the mail, and then you could read about what kind of research they were working on. And then you'll still have the mainstream channels like the TV and radio and, of course, magazines.
Are you planning to do more rap projects? Is there a particular subject that you like to rap about next?
I don't have more rap projects on at the moment, but sometime it might be nice to do a rap about natural selection, because I think that it's an idea that's misunderstood widely in the US. There are plenty of people who do understand it, but some people seem to really bristle against the idea.
Viral superstar or winner of the Nobel Prize? What would you like best?
For myself, I think it would be great to be a Nobel Prize winner, but I don't think I really have the talent for that, so I guess I had to go with viral superstar for a little while.
Okay. 27 kilometers tunnel underground, designed with mind to send protons around. A circle that crosses through Switzerland and France. 60 nations contribute to scientific advance. Two beams of protons swing round through the ring they ride, till in the hearts of the detectors they made to collide, and all the energy packed in such a tiny bit of room becomes mass particles created from the vacuum. And then
oh yeah.